Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to Learn Like Pro. In this video, we are going to learn the basics of jQuery starting from the syntax and along with classes and IDs. This is the syntax of jQuery. There is $of selector.action. Here $ represents jQuery. Instead of writing $, we can also write jQuery in the place of $. But in simple, we write $ instead of jQuery. And here selector. Selector is a HTML element on which you want to perform an action. So here we'll write a HTML element name, for example, a paragraph or a table or anything like that. So on which we want to perform a particular action. Then here the action. Action represents the particular action which we want to perform on this HTML element. And here I have shown an example. This is my HTML line which I have written. This is my paragraph tag and I have written some data inside the paragraph tag. And here in jQuery I'm writing $p.fadeout. This is $ and this is p, that is the paragraph tag. This p indicates the paragraph tag. We have to write the selector. So here p is the selector. We have to write the selector inside single quotes or double quotes. And .fadeout. So I want to perform a fade out operation on this data present inside the p tags. So here a simple predefined function performs fade out operation on the data. And here I am accessing the HTML elements into jQuery using p. And this function will be performed for all the p tags present in your code. If you write 10 paragraph tags in your HTML document, this fade out operation will be performed for all the 10 p tags written in your HTML document. And like this, you may want to write different operations for each of your p tags. If you have 10 p tags and you want to perform different operations for each of the p tag, in that case, we have to use selectors. There are two types of selectors, that is ID selector and class selector. And the ID and class selector have to be used like this. I have written p class equal to para, ID equal to para, and inside I have written some data and I have closed the p tag. So we have to assign a particular name for class and a particular name for ID. The class name and ID name can be same for a single HTML element, or otherwise you can assign different names for class and ID. And now, using these class names and ID names, we'll access these HTML elements into jQuery. Let's see the example here. Here I have written HTML, p class equal to data, and I have written, hi, this is jQuery. And here I have written p ID. For this I have taken ID, and for this I have taken class. And I have written some data inside the p tags. And now, see, for the first p tag, I am performing fade out operation. And for the second p tag, I am performing hide operation. Here I am accessing the first p tag using the class name, and the class name is accessed using dot operator, and the second p element I am accessing using id name, and the id is accessed using hash. This is very important to remember. The class is accessed using dot and the id is accessed using hash. So I am performing different operations for the two p tags. We can also perform different operations by providing different class names. A different class name here and a different class name here. Or otherwise using different ID names. A different ID name here and a different ID name here. We can also perform different operations by providing different class names and different ID names. And now, I have told you about classes and IDs. And both are performing almost the same functionality. Then why are we using class and why are we using ID? What is the difference between class and ID? So I'll tell you, an ID should be strictly unique. Your code may not work properly if you use same ID name for two or more elements. See, in this example, I have written ID equal to D1 for the first P tag and ID equal to D2 for the second P tag. And this is valid. And in the second example, I have written id equal to d1 for the first p tag and id equal to d1 for the second p tag also. And this is wrong. Your code will not work properly if you write the same id names for two or more elements. And whereas class name, the class name can be same or different for two or more HTML elements. See here, I have written p class equal to c1 for the first p tag and class equal to c1 for the second p tag also, and this is valid. We can write same class names so that we can apply a same kind of operation for these two p tags. And in another example, I have written p class equal to c1 and p class equal to c2. I have written two different class names, and here I can perform different operation for these both. So this is also valid. So this is the major difference. The class name can be same and the ID name should be unique. And now, the class name and ID for a single element can be same or different. That is, for a single element, the class name and ID name can be same, but the ID name and another ID name should be different. Or otherwise, the class name and ID name can be different also. Here I have written the same class name and ID name, and here I have written different class name and different ID name. So these both are valid. This is about the syntax of jQuery, the usage of classes and IDs in jQuery. We'll learn about the implementation of jQuery in detail in our next videos. For any queries, just comment below the video and we are ready to help you at any time. If you like this video, please do not forget to like and share it. And for more videos, please subscribe to our channel Learn Like Pro. Thank you.